For those of you that are fourth semester students who are going to be in charge and running the show, do not be afraid to put the second semester students to work. If you need something run somewhere, or cables run, or mics on stands, or stuff put away, or artists, drum bags and guitar cases stored somewhere, put them to work. There's no point in sitting around. You guys should get involved, get your hands dirty. That's what you need to do. All right. So, and if you are a second year student with nothing to do, approach somebody and ask, hey, do you need anything? And if they do, they do. If they don't, they don't. Okay. So make sure you get yourself to work. All right, now, for those of you that haven't seen this signal flow diagram before that I draw, prepare to be dazzled. For those of you that have seen it before, now, all right? That's all I got to say. All right, now, I'm just going to cover what's going on here. Things are kind of run all over the place. I'm going to try to get through this fast and quick, so pay attention.
But there's a video.
Yeah. Because by the end of all this,
YouTube,
this will look like a big mess. Right? So, here we go. Now, of course, we got our stage. We're gonna put our stage here, okay? Stage, all right. Now, coming from our stage, we have two subsnakes. Subsnakes basically are able to get us to the stage, to wherever we need to go, whether it's board, splitter, blah blah blah. We'll have two. We'll have a 1 through 12 and a 13 through 24. Subsnakes, okay? These subsnakes will be going to our whirlwind, whirlwind, 32 channel splitter. Alright? Now, basically what's happening there, we are taking all the mics that are on this stage and splitting it twice. Or wait, that doesn't make sense. We're splitting it once. Yes? Okay. That makes a little more sense. So we're splitting it, okay? Taking one signal, splitting it into two, okay? One of those signals is heading off into Ratland, down to A, down the hallway, through a corridor, left to right, and then wind up in Dave Kennedy's office, which is the machine room, sort of, and then from there going to A, okay? The other split is pertaining to here, all right? So what's coming off of there is going to our Allen and Heath. Allen and Heath. ZED 436. That is our mixing board. Okay? That is the board we're going to have. We're going to have it up stage or house left in the corner there, out of the way. And that's where the second split will come from our splitter. Oh, by the way, this is a three-way splitter. We could actually get a third split off of that whirlwind splitter if we wanted to. The idea is, especially out in a live venue where you have front house, you have monitors, and you have a recording end. You could split one signal three different ways, so each one could get an independent split. Okay? We only need two, because we just need front house and send it to rack. Now, coming out our left, right outs, left and right outs of our Allen and Heath is going into our EQ, which is our Behringer, let me get this, GEQ 3102, okay? That's a Behringer. It's a dual stereo 31 band EQ, okay? That is going to help us to EQ the house. To EQ our speakers, to make this room, if you notice, is a little tinny, now without the walls, if you remember from last time. We could shape the room how we need to make it sound halfway decent. Okay?
Why are the walls gone?
Jeff Donnelly, my new theater boss down here, technical director, this is his second year. He wanted a fresh start. These walls, the red walls, were up for probably about 20 years.
Sweet.
And we wanted to pull him out, and he wanted to start. So then that way, when we actually do shows, he could actually incorporate the depth of the space, use it as a natural black box. Eventually, I think he wants to remove these risers, but that won't happen for another 4 years, I think. But I think he wants to remove these. That's at least the thought. But that's why they were removed. He wanted a little bit more freedom and not be subject to what's already there. There we go.
It's all about theater. All right, meeting back. Coming out of our Behringer EQ, let me put EQ here. Coming out of that EQ, we're heading up into the booth. We're heading up into our processing unit, our DSP unit, which is a RANE, R-A-N-E, R-P-M 88, okay? So RAIN RPM 88, this is our DSP unit. What the DSP unit can do in this space and what we have it set up for, I could EQ the speakers out. We do have 5.1 surround sound in this space. We're not gonna use it for CRG. But I could take any signal and send it to any speaker through this. I could put delays, I could put limiters. It's a digital signal processing unit, okay? Now I bypassed the EQ because we are going to use the EQ down here. I want to have control of it because each band may sound a little bit different. We may need to EQ the house a little bit different, okay? I'll still have the limiter on, so that way, you know, if somebody's riding the faders kind of hot, I'll put a squash on it. But we don't have any of the speakers delayed and whatnot, but that's what our unit, this RANE, will do for us, okay? All right? Out of our RANE, coming out of one and two out, we are going to our M&K, I'm not sure if this is right, LFE 5.1 SDS, okay? This is used as our crossover point. Since we do have 5.1 surround sound in here, we actually need a bass management system in here. Now, bass management is somewhat like a crossover. I'm not going to get into the full details of it, but basically what this unit is doing is every input that we have, our left, our right, our center, our left rear, our right rear, are all coming into this unit, and what it's set at is anything that is 80 hertz and below is being taken away from all these speakers and being sent out the subs, which I'll get to in a second, okay? So basically what's happening is any channel that's coming in here, you know, left, right, center, left's around, right's around, if there's any signal that is 80 hertz and below, or any frequency 80 hertz and below, it's being taken away from those signals and sent to the subwoofers, okay? And I'll explain where the subwoofers are in a minute. All right, so basically we got the left and right, or channels 1 and 2 coming out of here, getting in here, out our left and right, okay? Left and right. Going to our, Apogee. Apogee. P3 processor. This is the processor for the speakers. Okay, you actually, I could actually put a little cut through this processor if I wanted to. It gives you it's small features. One thing it actually does is it protects your speakers. It shows you when you are getting in clipping. Usually these will actually shut down before the speakers blow, but that doesn't always happen. You know, it's not necessarily like an ultimate fail-safe. But it does give you some indication on how much signal is being sent. You could actually take down the attenuation, the amount of level being sent to your amplifiers if you need to, okay? It's a processing unit, all right? Out of this processing unit goes to our, QSC, make sure I get this model right, PLX 2502. This is our amplifier, okay?
I need two.
This is our amplifier, basically two channels of amplification, okay? What? Out of there, it's going to our, I'll draw them up here, because they're back here. AE3, there are apogees. Apogee, there's one here, and then there's one here above the stage, which are stage right, or I'm sorry, stage left, and stage right, house left, house right, okay? Those are the Apogee AE3s, all right? Those are our speakers, those are our front of house. Now, once again, this being more of a theater space, we actually have the speakers behind the band, which sometimes poses a bit of a problem when it comes to feedback and stuff like that, but that's where our EQ comes into place and helps us out, okay? But that is the signal flow for just the front of house, okay? Or I'm sorry, for the left and right mains,